Modern Family is fantastic, isn't it? Apparently, Ann Romney, Michelle Obama, it is their favourite show. I don't know necessarily that that in itself is anything of a recommendation. Ange Bishop, our entertainment reporter, actually went on set. Ange, how are you?
Very well, thanks. It does prove that it crosses the political divide, though, does it not?
True.
Which is pretty amazing for a show that features a gay couple who's adopted a child.
Indeed. It also proves it's a dysfunctional family, doesn't it, if you can have people from both sides of the political spectrum loving it?
Probably, yes.
The interesting thing, because I was talking to you earlier about the atmosphere there, it is actually like a family.
It is an unbelievably happy set. I've been on some sets where it's clear there are stars, there are favourites, there are people having tantrums and walking off to their trailers. Even when they had breaks, nobody went to their trailers. They just sit around, they talk to the gaffers, they
talk
to the crew.
That is so unusual.
When they all won, when they got, when the first series proved to be a hit and they got all the Emmy nominations and all the great critical praise, they were all bought an iPad, like everyone, cast all the way down to crew. And that way, they've sort of kept it as a family. So, of course, everyone tried to poach the writers didn't leave. So, as we go into season four, the writing is getting better and better and better because you've got the same team.
That is fantastic. And it actually does come down to the writing, doesn't it? I know all the components have to come together.
Yes.
The writing is brilliant.
Well, it's interesting. Ed O'Neill, who plays Jay Pritchard.
Who I love.
Oh, he's fantastic. I sat down with him and I said, what's the secret? You've been in a successful one before, of course, with Married with Children. And he said, you don't know. You don't know when you read the script, but you sort of get a feel. But it's interesting, he wasn't first choice for that role. Craig T. Nelson was offered the part and asked for more money.
Wow.
And he
because
out.
He is perfect for that role. Did you, just very quickly, from a lady's point of view, because
yes.
you're a lady,
yes.
when you were sitting down with Ed O'Neill, was there magnetism? Because he seems quite charismatic.
He's very charismatic, but I keep expecting the hand to go down the front of his trousers just from a Married with Children hangover. What can I say? But, no, he's lovely. And his best friends are an Australian family called the Bundys. No
I know.
Kidding.
How,
no
how
word
extraordinary
of a lie.
Is that?
They live next
how
door
extraordinary.
To each.
All right, one of the stars that you caught up with there and had a long conversation with Julie Bowen, who is the mum.
She plays Claire Dunphy. She just won the 2 Emmys on the trot for Best Supporting Actress. She is absolutely hilarious, but she's so down to earth. This is what happens when she goes to those big award shows like the Golden Globes. Have a listen.
You said that I get very starstruck.
Oh.
And there are people that I don't necessarily want to meet. Like, people will say, we were at some award show and Ed O'Neill knows Brad Pitt. And he goes, I'm going to go say hi to Brad. You want to come? And I said, no. No, I don't want to meet Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie. They are unicorns. I mean, they're magical creatures that I watch on TV and on the movies, and I'm okay with that.
She's quite, isn't she? She's very flamboyant with the hands, a lot of gesticulating.
Which is what she's
but
like.
She seems lovely. Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely fantastic.
A couple of quick questions about them. The eldest daughter, her eldest daughter in the show, who was very, very sick, but she's
Sarah
had
Harley,
a transplant.
Yeah.
How's she getting on?
She's fantastic. Loving being back on set and by all accounts feeling a lot better, which is terrific. Ariel Winter is also having a ball. She's the next oldest daughter who's been for a visit out to Australia earlier this year.
The new series, because they've made, well, this is series four, but there are over 20 in a series. I mean, they must be
working very hard.
Silly.
And of course, Gloria, Sophia's character, is pregnant
in
this
season.
In the
new series, she is pregnant.
Jay has to find out and all the rest of it.
Yeah.
So she's absolutely divine.
It doesn't surprise me that Ed O'Neill can still father an imaginary child on television.
You do love it, don't you? So season three's out on DVD. Season four, Channel 10, this Sunday night. Starts.
Brilliant. Thank you very much, Angela. Angela Bishop, our entertainment reporter.
Looking forward to that on Sunday night. I think that's going to be great fun.